Good afternoon, Bobcats, and welcome to BBTV, your home for Buffett News. Today is Monday, April 24, 2017. My name is Morgan, bringing you the news that matters. As always, let's begin with the daily announcements. Attention trio members, the next trio meeting for the new and old members have moved to Friday, April 28 during 8th grade lunch at 1220 in the community room. 8th graders who received a trio application and have not turned it in have until the end of this week to give it to Ms. Donahoe or Ms. Jorgensen in the counseling office and still be included in next week's meeting. Attention current 5th, 6th, and 7th graders. If any student is holding on their registration sheet for 2017 to 2018 school year, the counseling office needs it returned immediately regarding of whether you are to returning to Buffett or not next year. If you have lost your registration sheet, blank copies are available in the counseling office. Stop by and pick one up during Bobcat Den. Due to teacher conflict, April's Classic Film Club meeting will take place after school Thursday, April 27th. Please make sure to bring your ideas for the student choice film to April's meeting. If you aren't able to make it to the meeting, please let Ms. Kika know in room C209. That's it for the announcements today, Bobcats. Let's now head over to Jordan and Ellie for two quick news stories on a teenager who started his own business and a couple of big events coming to Omaha.
We will do almost anything to earn money. Brennan Angroff is a 17-year-old who needed some extra cash. He loves socks and took that passion and turned it into a business. He's the founder and CEO of his company, Hoopswag. Within the last 4 years, Brennan has made over $1 million by selling his socks. In the last few years, he has made over 200 original designs for the socks. His company will ship 70 to 100 packages every day. When Brennan started off, he sat in his basement and designed these socks, and now he is working in a 1,500 square foot building selling socks. He is the only graphic designer in this company, even though he is colorblind. So, Bobcats, it's time to form your opinion. Would you ever be able to start your own company?
OMAH hosted a lot of pretty big events. Things like the College World Series and Lady Gaga concert are just a few of the big names that have been found in our city. Recently, Omaha has just announced it will be hosting the NCAA Women's Volleyball Championship and the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament in 2020. The Women's Volleyball Championship will be held at the CenturyLink Center on December 17th through the 19th of 2020. This is the fourth time Omaha has held the tournament, and the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament, better known as March Madness, will also be returning to our city. The CenturyLink Center will also host two teams on March 20th of 2020.
What's up, Bobcats? It's Miracle here with another BBTV sit-down. Today's special guest is the director of the instrumental music for Buffett, Mr. John Meyer. Okay, so first off, thank you very much for taking the time out to let us interview. Okay, so today we'll be discussing National Jazz Music Month that has been happening all April long. So first off, what makes jazz special and why should students check out this genre of music?
Special because it's the fun. It's the way to express yourself through music that you don't get in other styles. It's completely unique to the individual because the soloing and improvisation, having a rhythm section, the piano, the bass, the drums, and that playing along behind you allows you to express yourself through an instrument like you can't do in other styles of music. And by the way, it's the only music that was created solely in America.
Okay. Our next question is all about Buffett's jazz band that you head up. What makes this group unique compared to some other of our musical groups?
Well, it's unique. It's the first time that many students will experience jazz. Mm-hmm. And I do admit they get into it for the fun, so I admit I do choose contemporary music. A lot of times the students choose. We play everything from Crazy Train by Ozzy Osbourne, believe it or not, Cupid Shuffle, some Santana tunes, and then I try and sneak in some classics. We're doing Take Five by Dave Brubeck and some other blues charts.
Okay. And then finally, what is Jazz Appreciation Month?
It's a national campaign that was founded by the Smithsonian Museum in Washington in 2002, so it's not that old. And there are many events throughout the state and the country, free museum showings, collections that are on display, other special events, teacher resources. So I would encourage all Bobcats to Google just Jazz Appreciation Month and read some about that. The posters that we have put, the students put downstairs near the cafeteria, while you're waiting in line, check those out. It's half of a Leroy Neiman painting that features Louis Armstrong, Ella Fitzgerald, Billie Holiday. And then next year, it will continue the feature of women in jazz, and it will complete the second half of the painting that hangs in the Smithsonian. So hopefully we'll hang on to those posters and have that up next year.
Okay, so thank you. That's all the time we have for the BBTV Sit Down. For more, I'll catch you next time.
Hey Bobcats, this is your sports anchor Tyler getting caught up with all the big things happening in the world of sports. Since it's Monday, let's begin with the BBTV 3 for 3, where we give you three games and three sports that are happening this week. Our first sport takes us to the world of basketball. Our game recommendation here is for the Warriors versus Trailblazers game happening tonight at 9:30. Moving over to baseball, be sure and check out the Pittsburgh Pirates as they take on the Chicago Cubs at PNC Park on Wednesday at 6:05. Our final game we think you should check out this week is in the MLB, where the Yankees are facing off again against the Red Sox on Thursday. Our prediction here is a victory for the Red Sox. That's it for the BBTV 3 for 3. Now we move into part 3 of our three-part interview with Tommy Frazier. In this segment, we talk to Tommy about his life after the spotlight.
What have you been doing outside of football?
Oh, recording the podcast with your dad to start off with. Business ventures, you know, coached at Baylor University for 5 years, and then moved back to Nebraska and coached at Doan College for 2 years. Now I'm a hospital administrator.
Are you still involved with the Huskers?
Not at all. You know, I don't do much down there. I'm too busy up here working and raising two kids. It's kind of hard for me to get down there.
What was it like being part of the College Football Hall of Fame?
That was a lot of fun, you know, because that being part of a Hall of Fame lets you know that you are one of the best. And, you know, I've never carried myself as being that, but it just solidified that what I did with my career, people noticed it and awarded me for my accomplishments.
What stopped you from playing professional football?
Injuries. I came down with blood clots again. That ones I had in college came out with them again. And once that came back when I was playing professional football, I decided it's enough is enough. It's time for me to retire.
Looking back, what is one thing that you're most proud of?
The way I played the game. The way I played a game and also graduated from college. I was the first kid out of my siblings and parents to graduate from college, so I think that's what I'm most proud of.
How's it going, Bobcats? This is Gio here to get you prepared for the next few days in the official BBTV 3-day forecast. Today it's going to be cloudy but warm with a high of 74 and low 51, and it's not going to rain. On Tuesday, it's going to cool off just a little bit with a high of 67 and a low of 47 with a 20% chance of rain. We hope you brought your weather gear because Wednesday is going to be a 60% chance of rain with a high of 63 and low of 49. We hope the track meet isn't canceled. That's all for the weather today. Now let's head over to the world of Twitter to see what our teachers have been tweeting about.
How's it going, Bobcats? This is Owen here for our daily feature. As always, let's begin by spinning our world-famous BBTV feature wheel to find out what our focus will be today. It looks like we landed on food, which means we'll show you some good foods to enjoy. Since it's track and soccer season, we're curious what the best foods to eat before competitions would be. We sat down to interview Nurse Boyer to find out. Check it out.
Before an athletic event, I would recommend something light. So a granola bar or a protein bar, even some fruit, so like orange slices or a banana. Just keep it light, nothing really heavy. Sometimes when you start running in an athletic event, that'll make you feel sluggish if you eat something high in fat, high in oil, like potato chips or even just like a heavy sandwich that can just weigh in your belly and slow you down or give you a belly ache.
Hi Bobcats, it's Sam again and welcome to Music Corner. Today we're talking about a different type of music group. This music group is called Pentatonix. Pentatonix is an a cappella group that consists of 5 people. An a cappella group is people who create music using no instruments. Pentatonix is one famous example of an a cappella group. They were formed in 2011 after winning a reality show called The Sing-Off. Since then, they have gone on a world tour and have won 3 Grammys. Currently, they have 13 million people subscribing to their channel and over 1.8 billion views. Check out this quick video of a few of their most popular videos. Now I really can't. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always... I see a little silhouette of a man. Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango?
When the light was cold, when the lamp was dry, I will stay.
That's going to do it for our broadcast today, Bobcats. For more info on many of these stories you've heard and to see what we're working on for future episodes, be sure to follow our Twitter page, @BuffettBBTV. Signing off, this has been Morgan. Have a terrific day, Bobcats.